Yes.
If this doesn't get you hype, I don't know what does.
I came prepared today, sir.
Are you gonna drop knowledge?
About to drop some knowledge on you. If you know Gipper, I'm very statistically sound, very statistically based. Love stats, love winning percentages. So I brought Mr. Jeff Sagarin's ratings today with us, from 09 through 07. So essentially, it's comparing Weiss and Kelly. It's gonna be fun.
Let's do that. We got 35 days to dissect it.
Well, let's start in 2009. At the end of last year, Cincinnati, per Sagarin rankings, ended up 8th in the country. But no, Cincinnati ended up 8th in the rankings last year, and our Fighting Irish, what did they end up here? I'm looking down here. They ended up 48th in the Sagarin rankings. Do you want to hear the teams that rated just, you know, above us?
Did Tulsa beat us? That's all I want to know.
Let me pull some teams. Let me drop some knowledge on you. Who ended up 49th? We're 48th. Who was 49th in the Sagarin rankings?
Please tell me it's Purdue.
William and Mary. Here's some teams that are ranked above us, friends. Central Michigan, Mississippi State, Kentucky, Oklahoma State, Navy, Air Force. I'm just picking the good ones out here. Villanova, all right. Southern Cal, stabbing the heart. Up to our favorite. Jerry Weiss, thank you so much. He did not play a top 10 team last year. So essentially, Kelly, when he was the coach, was 2-0 against top 30 teams. What was Weiss's record last year against top 30 teams?
0-3.
0-4. Cincinnati's 44th ranked schedule. Ours was 37th. Yikes. Yowza. Waka waka waka.
Well, you know, it's... Chuckles is gone, man. What's up?
I'm gonna drop some more knowledge on you. We're going back to 2008 in the second ranking. So this was the year. What happened in 2008? What was our record? We were 7-6 in 08. Cincinnati was 11-3. Cincinnati was 0-1 against top 10 teams and 2-2 against top 30 teams. All right? The strength of schedule for the Natty... The Natty Nap is 60th. Notre Dame, strength of schedule was 50th versus 60th, so relatively comparable schedules. What was Weiss's record against top 10 teams? 0-1. How about against top 30? Cincinnati was 2-2. Charlie Weiss, my friends, was
1-3.
0-4.
0-foe.
0-foe. So, as I said the last time, the last 2 years, he was 0-8 against top 30 teams the last 2 years. So everyone he had was against a non-top 30 team.
And these are like North Carolina, 25th.
Yeah, exactly.
Pittsburgh.
Exactly. I mean, these aren't...
Shitty, too.
With the exception of USC, I mean, we're not playing... I mean, Michigan has been just beyond atrocious.
No, it's... And when you let Ryan Mallett, a freshman quarterback, come in and dissect you, it's a sad day.
And then I'm going to go to my favorite year, 2007. Do you remember what happened in 2007, Mr. Simple Simon?
I pretty much deleted that entire year from my memory bank.
Notre Dame went 3-9. Cincinnati was 10-3. Brian Kelly's first year at Cincinnati, the strength of schedule for the Natty was 69th. And in Charlie Weiss's defense, his schedule was 24th strength of schedule. So that's, out of the 3 years, this is the 1 year Charlie Weiss did have a tougher schedule. Anyway, Cincinnati was 0-1 against top 10 teams and 2-1 against top 30 teams. What was Charlie Rice's record against top 10 teams?
0-1.
Yep. How about top 30 teams?
0-4 seems to be the pattern.
0-4. Again, 0-4. Oh, so in 3 years, the last 3 years of Charlie's career, he was 0-12 against top 30 teams.
That's a dirty dozen.
I mean,
that's a
sick statistic. I mean, really, if you look at it, it doesn't matter the 3-9. It doesn't matter the 7-6. The only reason Charlie won games is he didn't play that many teams in the top 30. I mean, he didn't beat one team in the last year in the top 30. That ended the season in the top 30. I got to give you more knowledge on top of that to let you know how bad this... I mean, this is even worse than it's sounding right now. About recruiting classes, not only was Charlie just atrocious in his last 3 years, 0-12 against top 30 teams, and Brian Kelly did obviously relatively well. Do you remember what those numbers were that I told you?
6-3
against top 30 teams. Now, you might say, well, 6-3 isn't that great against top 30 teams. Take 4 years before he got there, added them together and divided by four.
95.5. I saw it.
95.5. Let me repeat that. 95.5 recruiting talent. Obviously, recruiting classes aren't everything, you know. We understand that there's exceptions. Some 3 stars break it out. But seriously, I mean, the guy had nothing. I mean, last year he had two former quarterbacks starting on defense. Another battle won. Another story to tell. Listen to the angelic plucking of the puppy strings. Sir Lucius puts his left foot forward and glides off into the horizon of infinite regression. Victorious. Yeah. We're darn close to a top 10 talent this year, okay? Our schedule is a dumpster fire, to say the least. I mean, it is the worst schedule I've seen in Notre Dame history, and not to Kelly's fault.
It looks like Kevin White ate the paper and just puked it back up in random order.
But it's not necessarily even Kevin White's fault, because I mean, if you look at it, and I'm not defending Kevin White, but I mean, Purdue has been sick in the past. They're awful now. I mean, they're awful.
Yeah.
You look at USC.
Well, they're always good for calling the timeout on in the fourth quarter when there's 30 seconds left.
No, coach was our MVP last year. I mean, okay, our first game of the year is Purdue. What's Purdue's average recruiting class? 4 years. Ours is 11.25. What's Purdue's?
46.
62.5.
62.
I mean, we should beat Purdue like the O's money.
Yeah.
I mean, it shouldn't even be a game. They don't even belong on the field as a paper. I mean, what are some of our other tough games? BC. They're probably one of our tougher games, you'd say?
I hate BC.
What's their average recruiting class? 49.
USC,
well, 49th. Yeah, Utah. I think Utah is going to be our toughest game this year.
Probably.
I mean, because their coach is the best coach we're going to face. However, 51.75 is their four-year recruiting class average. So, I mean, they don't have a ton of talent.
We're going to be undefeated right there. So, we're talented enough. We're playing well enough. Can we handle the hype, or are we going to go into choke mode? That I think if we lose one game this year, that would be the game.
Michigan State, 34th, four-year average. All right, and here's the only two teams with talent that we play all year long that even deserve to even walk on the field with us is number two, Michigan Wolverines. Though Rich Rodriguez, Dick Rod as I affectionately call him, his average for 4 years is 12.5 versus 11.5.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. Michigan still has a ton of talent, man. If they get a good coach in that, like, I hope Rich Rod stays.
Yeah.
I hope they hire, like, some putz politically correct jackass, you know. I hope they get, like, Ferentz out of Iowa, some guy with 50% winning percentage, you know. Because...
Yeah.
They have a ton of talent, man. If they get a guy in there, if they got like Irby there, I mean, obviously they wouldn't, but I'm saying if they got a guy like that, or like Chris Peterson of Boise State,
yeah.
Oh my gosh. I wouldn't want to play him.
No, I wouldn't either.
We have equal talent in Michigan, and I feel like Kelly's a better coach. His winning percentage is great. I mean, the game is at Notre Dame this year.
It's at Indy.
I mean,
and Michigan's under pressure, and they know it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, especially if...
Well, hey, look, maybe it'll just rain, and they'll fumble 8 punts and kickoffs. And
I think it's Rich Rod's last year. And I'm sad to say that because I don't think he's that great. I mean, he could barely... I mean, if you can't... Let's face it. If you can barely beat Charlie Weis, you got some issues.
Yeah. To make it more interesting, lying to yourself like it really happened. Really happened. It's like we're riding on a never-ending train. Shoot, shoot. Pick a stop, pick a stop, pick a lie, pick a lie, pick a reason to convince them that it never happened. I guess nobody really cares when we're all laughing. I think your lie just saved the day.